We continue our series about excessive regulations, tonight focusing on small business. Chief Washington correspondent James Rosen reports, while the companies may not be large, the rule books they must follow are getting bigger all the time. James?
Brett, good evening. There are close to 28 million small businesses in the United States, and they employ more than half of all private sector workers. One problem is that as he hires more people, a small business owner will often not know about new regulations he faces until after he's been found in violation of them, or perhaps even fined. Businesses with just one employee face right off the bat at least 10 federal regulations, including predictable ones like Social Security, but also the Polygraph Protection Act. Grow your business to 25 employees, and you face all of those, plus a whole new raft of them, including the Older Worker Benefit Protection Act. Surely every pizzeria owner has that memorized. And the list grows like a beanstalk when your company grows to 100 employees. Last year, we saw a distinct rise in the number of proposed federal rules affecting small businesses. You can see from 758 to 845. And the smaller a firm is, fewer than 20 employees, say, the more expensive it gets per employee to comply with those regulations. Five federal agencies last year proposed 501 of those 845 rules we're talking about, roughly 59% of the total. They are the Departments of Agriculture and Commerce, Health and Human Services, the Environmental Protection Agency, and the Federal Communications Commission. Now, President Obama has pledged to streamline and pare back the U.S.'s regulatory burden, but with limits.
I reject the argument that says for the economy to grow, we have to roll back protections that ban hidden fees by credit card companies, or rules that keep our kids from being exposed to mercury, or laws that prevent the health insurance industry from shortchanging patients.